Hi guys, it's Michael from Svitlov Temerovich channel, and today I want to show you difference between end user access and master access on Luxpower inverters. By default, end user access is intentionally limited, not to annoy you, but to protect your system. You are restricted from changing key settings, so you don't accidentally activate something that could make your system work inefficiently or even worse, shut it down completely or trigger protection fault code due to critical parameter violations. Now, let me show you exactly how it works. I'll compare two access levels side by side on the screen. Here is, for example, an end user access for a station that is working hybrid setup for making electricity bill lower without sell back additional power. In this case, we can see that what now is going on. Three of there are some kind of lithium battery that it cannot be connected to this inverter because the CAN protocol is not supported. But in any case, now we can see what was total amount yield, what is total discharge of the battery. You can click here to change settings for see what total charged. So the difference is almost twice. It means that total discharged and total charged will, if you will divide these numbers, you will get the efficiency of the battery usage. In this case, I can tell that it's not efficient. Battery is installed here more for backup power, not for optimization of solar generation. So total usage, today yield. It's like simple as that. Here you can see a chart what was going on during the day. So as you can see, the state of capacity battery was almost 100% all of the time. And even when load was more than solar can provide, it was not discharging battery, but taken from the grid. And in this case, where you can see the red line lower the zero, it will show that you are importing the grid power, so you will pay for it after. Here you can see the chart of the energy overview, so it means that what was going on during the day, so it is integrated data for full day, full 24 hours. You can change the months, you can change for yearly, so it will be monthly charts, integrated data, or total, it will show the yearly generation, consumption, and battery charging and discharging. Here you can also add or delete some additional information that you can be also interested in, and it is the end user access. In this case, if you would like to change battery or make your system work some different style, in case if you want to improve efficiency of this system, the most common way is to make end of discharge voltage lower, so battery can be discharged a bit, like to 53 volts or something like that. So in this case, in a sunny time, your battery plus solar energy will provide energy to the load if load will get more than your sun can get now. And after your load is disabled, your inverter will charge your battery from the solar. In case of this station, we can see that solar panels can provide much more electricity than average usage of this house. It's generating 4 kWh. So if we will check a few days before when we have seen more consumption on the day, so like in 9th of June, we switch to data chart, total solar power provided, click to the 9th, and we can see that the solar panels can certainly generate more than 3 kWh. But daily, in this type that is now, it is making only 4 kW. It not mean that in this region, the sun is shining on the system just 1 hour. No, it's just because of the all of the time, solar panels are used less than 10% of its rated power. In this case, to improve efficiency, first that you need to do, you need to change your day plan. You need to make some dishwashing machine and washing machine and some maybe charging some batteries in the daytime, so you will increase your consumption during sunny time and decrease it during the nighttime. In this case, you will improve your efficiency just free of charge. You will just use more sun energy, not the nighttime energy. But what you can change in end user settings. Here is some kind of fancy chart, but it's not very informative. You can switch to old user settings and you can see what is available for you. So here we see the AC first. It means that inverter will prefer to use grid before using battery or sunlight. And in this case, I can see that it's enabled during the all day. So if you will disable this function, so let it be from 00 to 1:59 a.m. It's certainly nighttime and sun is not shining at this time. So export to grid is disabled just because of the legal situation. The owner cannot make different agreement to sell back the power, so let it be. So here you can switch for like 54 volts and it will be affected. So here is the generator charge settings and discharge settings. The end of grid voltage is the minimum voltage that will allow battery to discharge to in case of grid are available also. So when your battery will be discharged for this number, it will switch to provide your consumption by solar power plus grid power without using any battery power. So let's put here the 53 volts. In case that battery now is 55, so we have 2 volts difference to use some kind of battery. It's like about 15% of total capacity. It is all that you can see in end user access. If we switch to master access, we will see the same chart in monitoring system. We can add the weather forecast for this area. And you can see the forecast now is raining. It not should be lots of power. But today yield, if you will use it, will be 6.5 in rainy and part cloudy. And we can see that mainly we've got about less than 4 kWh generation per day. So even this day is rainy, your system can be able to generate almost 1.5 times more than you use. Let's switch to the maintenance and see what type of settings is available to change for the master access. We see like much more information here. So one more time we'll compare. Here we can see it's just application settings. So AC first, charge settings, discharge settings, and reset. And in master access, we can see common settings. Application settings, we have seen that there was just AC first and all. Here we can also see the parallel settings, hybrid settings, EPS voltage settings, AC input range, NPA bond, EPS frequency, PV grid off. So it's like much more in every settings point. Charging settings is available to switch not only charge voltage but floating charge, and it's very necessary to be able to choose the correct number for exactly your battery in case of usage, not battery that support CAN protocol with the inverter. Equalization for this time is disabled because of the lithium battery have its own balancing system and it don't need to be equalized. Here we can see also AC charge, generation charge. For discharge, we can see not only discharge control, but AC couple and smart load as additional. And smart load is getting a point that you can use your gen port not to diesel or gasoline generator, but to use it to some kind of load that you are willing to use only in case of you have like more sun energy that you can use. So generally, you can use it for heating water, heating swimming pool, heating some kind of floor under your car in the garage or something like that, just to move energy somewhere and not to throw it out. Here you can also see the changing speed of fan. In case of the inverter is very noisy for you, you can make it less, but I don't recommend put it lower than 50% of maximum speed because of the heating problem. If inverter is installed in some kind of basement or not very hot space, you can make it 50 or 45. If inverter is next to your roof or any other place where temperature outside can be more, please don't put it even 70. Make it 100, make it 90. Be sure that inverter can relieve of that heat. Here you can also set the cluster of your inverter. It's important if you have a few inverters and want to get in the parallel system, and if the inverter you have bought firstly and secondly was like in different years. Mostly inverters made before 2023 is connected to Asia cluster, and if you buy a new one, trying to make parallel system from new and old one, you need to change clusters to the same. You can make update, you can see what was the last update, you can make the remote update for your inverter. Choose the station first so you can see that one station it enabled for you. So you can see what is going on with inverter. So here is three types of software that need be updated. You can see the, you can click the update policy and click start update. In case of you would like to make your system more efficiently, you can contact me on this link below and I can help to set up your system to your own needs and make it more efficient. So if you want to get a full access, contact me directly. I offer technical consultation, help with proper configuration, and can recommend you the right equipment for your exact needs. No, I don't ship hardware globally, but I do provide battle-tested experience and solution based on over 3 years of working through power instability during the wartime in Ukraine. If you're tired of guesswork and want systems that just work, message me. Let's make your setup bulletproof. I would like to thank to all of you guys. Your support is very important for me. So please click like and follow a button. If you would like to see more English videos, please put it in the comments below. I'll try to make some more content based on your feedback.